Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I am posting all of these videos on keto recipes and holiday tips to help you get through this holiday season. So if you are into that and want to watch more, make sure you subscribe and check out my playlist that has all of my keto Vlogmas videos in it. So today I want to share with you guys some keto holiday travel tips. This time of year, there is a lot of people out there that travel, and trying to stay true to your goals and keto diet can be kind of hard because you're out of your normal element. So I'm going to have some tips and tricks for you to help you stay on your keto diet this holiday season. Tip number one is to pack your own food. Make your own meals ahead of time, pack your snacks ahead of time, and bring them with you. This is especially, it's a lot more easier if you're traveling via car because you could bring a cooler with and bring your own food in there and have your snacks and stuff like that. It's harder to do when you're on an airplane, but you can still pack some non-perishable snacks with you. So some ideas are like hard-boiled eggs are a great one, pork rinds, those Parmesan crisp, you can make those pepperoni chips in the air fryer and put those in a baggie and bring those. I love to do, like, if we're looking for a meal to eat on the road, I like to do the fathead dough that's wrapped around a hot dog. My kids like that. My husband likes that. It's easy to eat when you're just driving. But you could always do nuts and cheeses, salami. There's just all sorts of easy stuff like that that you can do. Also, avocado is another one. I actually do that a lot when I'm late for work and don't have time to pack my lunch, but an avocado is really easy, especially to pack it in your bag if you're flying. And then, I guess you can't bring a knife, but if you already have it pre-cut, and then just scoop it out. It's so delicious. It's fatty. It's filling. It's like the ideal keto food. And another good snack would be to bring sardines. Sardines are something else I like to bring too when I'm going to be on the road traveling. So my second tip when you're traveling is to take advantage of gas station food. Like, you're going to be surprised at how many keto things are at a gas station. Not just beverages, because I usually get like a coffee, and then they might not have heavy cream, but I might splurge a little bit and do the half and half creamer. But get a coffee. They've got the sparkling waters now. Water is another good choice. Some people like to drink diet sodas, so they have that there. It's not just that stuff. Like, a lot of gas stations nowadays actually have like hard-boiled eggs or the big pickles or the salami and prosciutto wrapped cheese sticks. A lot of those have those nowadays. And then of course they have the nuts, and there's some jerkies that are pretty low in carbohydrates too that you could always get there as well. So take advantage of gas stations. Like, if you're getting hungry, go to the gas station. Don't be tempted by the chips and the cookies and the candy. Just head straight to their little deli section, and you should be able to find those items in there. Tip number three is fast food. And there's lots of information on Instagram and Pinterest and Google of what are some keto fast food ideas. One of our favorites is going to McDonald's and getting their like an egg McMuffin thing with just like the sausage and the cheese and the egg, and asking, either ditching the biscuit or asking that they remove it, because they can make those all bunless. All of their stuff they can make bunless and accommodate you. But we'll do Carl's Jr. makes the lettuce wrap burger. I've done Jimmy John's before. I've done Subway with getting their salad. Another thing you can do is just buy a package of those low carb wraps ahead of time and bring that with you. And you could take something like a salad from Subway or even Jimmy John's lettuce wrap and roll that in a wrap. And so it feels like you're having something more because there's that wrap version in there. Yeah, but when it comes to fast food, just look for, if you want chicken, get the grilled chicken options. Add extra bacon to like burgers or your breakfast option if you're getting that. You have to be careful with what's in guacamole sometimes, but you should be able to look that up on the internet to see what the nutrition is in their guacamole, if you could have a side of guacamole with that too. So my fourth tip is when you're at the airport, and there's actually, I feel like airports are a lot easier than when you're traveling by car because, and I guess it depends on the airport that you're in, but the majority of them have tons of restaurants and there's always going to be versions that of keto versions that you can eat when you're at that restaurant. So all of them have the same fast food or they have a sit down place where you could just order a bunless burger or a steak or some grilled chicken. So there's lots of things that you can do there at the airport. And if you are traveling by plane, again, bring your own snacks with you. Bring the avocado, bring your own nuts with you. Ditch those ones that they give you on the airplane ride, that little snack mix. Don't do that. Don't be tempted. Just stick with bring your own to eat or stick with just their beverages. And that's another good tip is to stay hydrated too when you're on the plane. Not only is it pretty easy to get dehydrated when you're traveling, but this will help keep you satiated too by drinking extra water while you're on your flight. And my last tip is to bring your own food. I already kind of mentioned that. Pack a cooler if you're driving by car to bring all of your favorite keto foods to wherever you're going, like your parents' house, friend's house, relative's house, so that you have something you can eat when you're there because they might not be as accommodating to you since you're on this diet. Or if you're traveling by flying somewhere, or even if you're traveling by car, just go to the grocery store once you get there and find your favorite keto favorites. Like find your butters and your eggs and bacon, your heavy cream, avocados, whatever is going to help you stay successful while you're away from home at somebody else's house. Go buy it once you get there. Well, I hope that these tips help you stay keto as you're traveling to go visit friends and family. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any of my upcoming future videos I'm going to have on the keto diet, tips and tricks to help you get through the holiday season. Have a good day, guys.